what most artists are signing are royalty rate deals, right? In a royalty rate deal, let's say a new artist standard, if you got a good lawyer, you're getting a 17% royalty rate deal, right? Nowadays, right? Okay. Versus a profit split deal. And let's call it a 50% profit split deal. Now, the thing with the royalty rate deal, the pros are that the label's not taking expenses off the top. So when they're doing their marketing budget and whatever, it's not coming off the top, right? A profit split it is. That used to work back in the day when the expenses they were taking were packaging, distribution, etc., mechanical royalties. Now that streaming has come along, the expenses that a label will be taking off the top have decreased so much that you're better off just getting the profit split. Because now if it's 17% or if it's 50%, now granted, back in the day, it was 17% of a bigger pot, right? Because the expenses didn't get taken off the top, but the profit split didn't. It still does. The thing is that the expenses getting taken off the top nowadays of the profit split, because of streaming, it's just so minuscule that you still end up getting a bigger percentage, which is why you need to take a profit split. But a lot of these artists, they just, $600K, $1 million, say less. But here's the problem is that y'all not doing the math. Y'all, first of all, y'all not getting $1 million, but let's call it $1 million. So you get $1 million, y'all are idiots, so you're paying your manager 20%, you're paying your lawyer 5%, and you're paying your business manager 5%, right? So that's 25-5. Was that 30%? So 30% of your $1 million advance, done. That's 300,000 off the top. So you got 700,000 to work with. You only need about 400,000 a year to be in the top tax bracket, right? The top tax bracket, we're going to call it 50 because it's 43 estate plus the 5 federal, whatever the fuck. Let's just call it 50. So you got 700,000, so cut that in half, right? What's half of 700,000? 350? So you got 350,000 net. This is before you buy anything. So really, your $1 million deal is only you gross. But so from 2011 to 2014, I put out 11 projects, and I'm broke, and I'm not successful. I have 1,000 followers, and I'm like, all right. Well, at a certain point, you got to look at yourself and be like, maybe it's me. You know what I'm saying? So I'm like, all right. I'm like, nah. The music. I was always confident in the music. I started questioning the approach. And so I started looking at that time, SoundCloud was still, to me at least, it was new. And I was like, man.
We're in 2014.
2014. This is fall 2014. So I started looking at SoundCloud, and I'm like, and I'm looking at plays, and I'm noticing that the most amount of plays on every artist's SoundCloud, when it comes to them dropping an album, it was the first song, or it was a big feature, but mainly the first song. And then it would tail off. So yeah. I was like, oh, what this tells me about consumer behavior is that everyone is down to listen to one song. It's just that second song, we're out,
yeah. You
know? So I was like, okay, what if I just drop one song albums every week? Because I'm dropping 3 albums a year. Let's call it 14 songs.